In this video, we're going to take a look at what's new with the Maps app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at what's new with the Maps app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Let's go over to my iPhone. So I am using an iPhone 15, and of course it is using iOS 18. Let's go ahead and open up the Maps app to see what is new. I tap on it, and now we're looking at the Maps app. Basically what they've done is they split this in two. So you're going to see that it's split in two here. Above it is my map, and then below it are going to be the places that I've recently visited, or maybe my guides. What I do is I like to think of this as a card. This is basically what is new, this card. So all I need to do is just swipe up and I can view all of the different places. So I'm going to swipe up. You're going to see we have a little horizontal line here. I just drag that up and we can view all of the different places here. So this is divided into different areas here. The first thing is I can search. So I can easily search for any location. Below that, we have Siri suggestions. So I've recently searched for that. So that's just Siri suggestions. And then we have a library. Now this is all new. The library consists of different places, guides, and routes. These are different places that you've saved, different guides that you've added to the Maps app, or even different routes that you've created. More on that in a little bit. That's another new feature. So this library is where all of your stuff that you've saved is going to be found. Now below that, we also have our recent. So when we go down towards here, this is all the recent places. So when I search for something, it'll show up here. So this is the card that has really changed, and everything that you can find within the Maps app is located in this card. Now let's take a closer look at this library. This is all new. When I tap on this, actually what I need to do is I need to tap on this here. You can see it comprises of 15 places, 7 guides, and 0 routes. We'll create a route in a little bit. But basically when I tap on that text, what it does is it shows me all of the different locations that I've pinned, as well as the places that I've saved, my guides, and my routes. And then below that, we can see what has been recently added. So let's go ahead and take a look at this Chicago pizza. What I would like to do is I would like to pin this, so then it will show up under pinned here, and I'll show you where you can find that easily. And I would like to go and add a note. We can also add notes to this. So to do that, what we do is we just go and tap on the more button here, the three dots, the ellipsis. So let's go ahead and tap on it. We're first going to pin it. So I just tap on pin. When I tap on pin, what it's going to do is it's going to pin that place. So it's going to be located in this area here. So when I tap on pin now, you're going to see that I have Chicago pizza. Now when it is pinned, let's go ahead and close this. I'm going to tap on the X right up here. When I do close this and we close our library, tap on the X again, being that it is pinned, you're going to see that it shows up on the main screen. So when you pin it, it does show up on the main screen. You don't actually have to go into the library and look at pinned. Let's take a look at how we can add notes. I mentioned that we could add notes as well. So now I'm going to go back into the library. I just tap on this. And we're going to go over here to Chicago, and I tap on the three dots again. And this time what I'm going to do is add a note. Let's just go with Great Pizza. So I type in here Great Pizza. And tap on Done. And now that note has been added. So where can I find this note? Well, when we go back over to that location, let's just go ahead and tap on this. I could tap on my pinned location, or I can tap on this. Basically, I want to get the details of a location, what their hours are, maybe where their location is, what their phone number is. And now, with notes, I can also see any notes that I've added in there. And this will sync across all of your different devices as long as they're using iPad OS 18 or later, or Mac OS Sequoia or later. To close this card, we just go back up to the top here and tap on the X. And it closes that card. And then when I swipe down, I can get back to my map. So that is the new library. So what else is new? Well, as I mentioned earlier, we can create our own route. Let's say that you're a runner or you're a walker and you want to create a walk or a run for a 5K, 3.1 miles. How can you do that? Well, basically what we need to do is we just need to go back to our library. So what I'm going to do is go back over to my library here. And then what we do is we go over to routes. And when I tap on routes, what I'm able to do is create my own route. So let's just go ahead and do this. We're just going to do a real quick route. We have a snowmelt system in downtown Holland, which is great for runners and walkers in the middle of the winter. All of our sidewalks are basically heated and they melt the snow. So what I would like to do is create a route in downtown Holland. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to tap on create route here. Now what I need to do is I need to go to my location. So I'm just going to go across the lake here. We're going to swim across the lake. We're going to go into Holland here. I'm just going to go to downtown. And generally, what I do is I will park in this parking lot here. So let's just go ahead and drop a pin there. This is where I'm going to start walking. So I'm just going to go to that area there. We can see that I dropped a pin right there. So that's the start. So now all I need to do is just drop a pin and it'll create the route for me. And it'll tell me how long and even the elevation. This is going to be relatively flat. Holland is relatively flat, but you're going to kind of get the idea of how it all works. So let's just go ahead and drop some more pins. So I'm just going to swipe over here. I walk over to this corner here. So I just drop a pin there and we can see that it drew a line there. And now what I'm going to do is keep going. We're just going to go all the way down to 7th Street and we're going to go over here. I could have just dropped the pin there as well. And now it's going to draw it all the way over there. Now I'm going to go down to 8th Street. So I drop a pin here. And we're going to just keep going here. Keep dropping some pins. Central Avenue has snowmelt. So I'm just going through here, dropping pins. And it will even turn corners for us. So what I'm going to do, normally I would just drop a pin here, right? But watch what happens when I swipe over and I drop a pin over here. It's actually going to put that route in there for me. And we can see that it put the route in there for me. So it keeps me on the path. It's not going to allow me to cut through a building per se. And if we look down towards the bottom, we can see how long it is and the elevation. And when we are done, let's just say that I am done now. What I need to do is I need to close this. Is this going to be an in and out or is this going to be a loop? Well, it's only 0.9 miles, so let's just go with an in and out. So how do I do that? Well, basically I go back over to the original spot here. And when I tap on this, I have the option, sorry, not in and out, it's called out and back. I have the option to reverse the route, create an out and back, which means it's going to retrace the steps. And then it's going to be basically double the length, or what I can do is just close the loop. So let's just go ahead with an out and back to make it a little bit longer. So I just tap on out and back. And now we can see that it is 1.7 miles. So I just created a route. And you can do this through trails, you can do this through neighborhoods, wherever there are public sidewalks or hiking trails. So when I'm done, all I have to do is just tap on save here, and it's going to save that route. From here, I can go and name it, and I can even download it. So if I'm in an area where there's not internet connection, I'd be able to download this. So I'm going to tap on done up here, and that route is now saved. And it is called West 8th Street. So now, when we go over to my routes, we can see we have that route. And if I wanted to walk it, all I have to do is just tap on it and go the directions. And we can see that it is downloading it right now. So it's going to be on my phone. I don't need to have an internet connection to view that route. So that is the new routes. In addition to that, we also have hiking trails built into the Maps app. So how do we find hiking trails? Oh, we just go back over to our main screen here. And then all you have to do is just search for hiking in here. So let's just go ahead and search for hiking. I'm going to go with hiking here. I'm going to search nearby. And you're going to see all of the hiking trails that are nearby. And then what I'm able to do is just swipe up from the bottom here and view all of those hiking trails. So let's go with Riley Trails. I tap on it. And now we can see that trail. And when I swipe up, I can see the photos for it, as well as rate it, add my own photos, and even visit the website. And then if I wanted to pin it so I can go to that trail easy, I can also just pin it. And it's going to show up in my library. So that's how we can easily find hiking trails near us. Now, in addition to that, they improved, speaking of near us, they improved the search. So basically, when you search for something and then you move the map, so I search for hiking trails in this area here. But what I'm going to do is move the map over, so I'm looking at Chicago. So I just swipe over. Typically, what would happen when you do that is it doesn't repopulate. You're going to see it's not repopulating those hiking trails. So now, what do you do? Well, what they have is a new search here. So I'm actually going to close this. We're looking at one trail here. So I'm going to tap on the X here. And X. And now we're going to go with hiking trail in Holland. We're just going to start over here. There's all the hiking trails. And as I said, when I move, you're going to see that it is bringing up different hiking trails. But every once in a while, it doesn't do that. It may miss the hiking trails. Well, when I move the map around, you're going to see Red Dawn towards the bottom here. You're going to see search here. And it's going to search there automatically. But if it doesn't, in some cases it doesn't, what you can do is you can tap on that button. Now, it seems to be behaving pretty good right now, so I won't have to tap on it. So just keep your eye out in this area here as I move it around. So I'm just going to move up towards Wisconsin here, and you can see searching here. I move again, searching here. So it's behaving pretty good today. But in the past, you weren't able to do that. Now what you can do is if it doesn't find location, so you could type in here pizza. Let's just go with pizza. And whoops, we got to type in here pizza, not hiking trails pizza, although that would be good, wouldn't it? So I'm just going to go with pizza nearby. I don't know that I'm in Wisconsin right now, so I'm going to go with pizza nearby. And it's like, whoa, wait, no, I'm not in Wisconsin here. I'm in Holland. So we're going to go swimming across the lake. And we can see that. I have all the pizza joints. And we have search here. Now, being that I was scrolling around, it didn't actually update that search here. So this is what I can do now, is I can actually just tap on that button. And when I do, it's going to refresh that search. And there's all the pizza joints within that area. So that's how that search here works. In most cases, as you saw, it will update. But in some cases, as you saw, it doesn't update. So what you can do is you can use that as a button. So those are the main new features that we have with the Maps app on the iPhone with iOS 18. We have a little bit of a redesigned interface, making things a little bit easier. Everything's under one card. Also, we can find our library, which has all of our different locations that we've pinned or saved, or even routes that we've created. On top of that, we can go and add notes to any location, and they'll show up in that locations card. And then we can also search for different hiking trails near us. And when you do search for something that is near you and you move the map, it should update automatically. But if it doesn't, what you can do is you can have it search in the new location for what you were looking for, like I was showing you with pizza or even hiking trails. So that is what is new with the Maps app on the iPhone with iOS 18. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You may want to share it with your friends and family. Also, if you want to help support my site, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. Even though I have over 400 videos on YouTube, my site I've been maintaining a lot longer than YouTube, so I have a lot more videos on my site, danstutorials.com. It is a membership-based site, so that's how you can help support my efforts. When you become a member, I take out all of the ads for the video, so you're not going to see any ads on the videos. You also have access to an AI assistant that I modeled after an Apple Genius. And you have access to classes and webinars that I hold on a regular basis. And last, you also are helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization or anything like that. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out Dan's tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching.